In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Today, 28th Sundays in the cycle B, I greet all everybody in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today the first reading is from the Book of Wisdom. The writer is saying that he preferred wisdom because of that he has everything. He has all possession. I preferred her to the scepter and throne. Deemed riches nothing in comparison with her. All gold in comparison with her is a little sand. I loved her beyond health and bodily attraction. But Solomon, who said to have written these verses, later fell away from the way of wisdom. The Book of Sirach explains his downfall like this. But you, he speaks to Solomon, but you brought in women to lie at your side, and through your body you were brought into subjugation. You brought yourself into subjugation of the ladies. The gospel, we find a young man faced with a challenge of following Jesus. What shall I do to inherit eternal kingdom? Jesus told him, obey the commandments. Obey the commandments. And Jesus told, yes, something is lacking in you. You go and sell all what you have and come and follow me. The man went sad because he was rich. He, instead of following Jesus, he followed wealth. He wanted to follow his wealth. And Jesus allowed us, you can go. We in our prayer service often sing the song, all to Jesus I surrender, all to him I freely give. This story it has come from the Methodist background. But anyway, it is a Christian song. All to Jesus I surrender, all to him I freely give. A young man was going to be ordained a priest. His father had some legal conflicts with some neighbors about financial matters. The young man told the father, give up every court cases before my ordination. That is a Christian decision. That is a decision for Jesus Christ, for the glory of Jesus Christ. Give up material things. For the sake of Jesus, give up your money matters. This is a simple example of preferring Jesus to material things. I have heard a story of a priest. Before his death, he kissed his money bag. Another young man who saw this was so much scandalized, and he decided to give up the world. And worldly things, he went to a monastery and joined the monastery. That is a Christian decision. Preferring Jesus to every other material things. Jesus, this is the verse of Jesus, whoever comes to me and does not hate father, mother, wife and children, brothers and sisters, yes, even life itself, cannot be my disciple. Luke chapter 17. It is easy to sing Jesus in the morning, Jesus in the noontime, Jesus when the sun goes down. But there are certain moments of life where our decision to follow Jesus becomes a challenging one, a terrible one, a crucial decision, most excruciating pain we have to pass through. For example, death of our dear ones. We are traumatized. The whole family is thrown into confusion. One who was supporting the family has done it no more. There we have to stand our ground. When we are affected by a serious sickness, we are praying, we were doing all devotional things, we were loyal to the church, loyal to Jesus, everything, but we fell sick. then what is the decision what we are making? Financial crisis in the family, financial crisis in the personal lives, all these are situations where, challenging situations where we have to abide by the faith in Jesus Christ. In such a crisis moments, best prayer we can make is, bend my will to your will, O Lord. Not my will, your will be done. When we decide to follow Jesus, various forces try to distract us. We have heard the example of Solomon. Solomon preferred wisdom in the beginning of his life, but he did not continue to the end of life. It is not that we begin something, but we have to continue to the end of our life. He followed his own passions. In the parable of the sower, we find the seeds that the sower has taken. As some are on the way, it was fallen on the wayside. Some have fallen on the rocky ground. Some have fallen in thorny, bushy area. Only some reach the end of it. How it is, I explained in another sermon already. And this is the challenges we face in our day-to-day life. When we follow Jesus, there are a lot of distractions that come on our way. Jesus wants us, be on your guard so that your hearts are not weighed down with the dissipation and drunkenness and worries of life. We must be engaged in the world positively. We should positivate the lives of the people. But we must not be engrossed in the world. Hold on to the basic commitment to Jesus Christ in our day-to-day life. There are day-to-day decisions we make, and whether how far we are loyal to Jesus is important at the end of the day. And at the end of the day, what we have done for Jesus that remains successful. We may be in business, we may be in politics, we have family cares and we have to attend to the needs of the family. In all these decisions, matters, we have to decide and stand by the decision of Jesus Christ. We must examine at the end of the day, did I do it according to my Christian convictions? I am basically responsible to Jesus. My life should be open before Him. Death must not meet us off our guard. We must not be taken off our guard. We begin the day surrendering everything to Jesus. At the end of the day, we come again, surrendering everything that has happened on the day to Jesus. For us, Jesus is not an idol that to be worshipped. It is a living reality that is within us, that is continuously together with us. Follow him. All glory to him. All glory and power, adoration and thanksgiving, now and always and forever. Amen.